wa nafa'ni wa iyyakum bil ayati wa dhikri hakim. Astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'ilil mu'minin wastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. Subhanaka la 'ilma lana illa ma 'allamtana innaka antal 'alimul hakim. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wahlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Rabbi yassir wa la tu'assir wa tammim bil khair wa bika nasta'in ya fattah ya fattah ya fattah. صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم الأمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله. It's a great blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has given me and you the ability and tawfiq to participate in this gathering. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this gathering a source of guidance for all of us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this gathering one of the means of our entry into Jannah. Inshallah, tonight we are going to talk about the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan. Because I believe this is the most important topic now. We are in the first odd night of the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan. And these last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan are the holiest time of the entire year. So we should be so grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah has given us this opportunity. We are in the 21st night of the month of Ramadan. Allah has taken qasam. Allah has given a qasam upon these last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan. Wal fajr wa layalin ash. Allah swears by dawn, and then Allah swears by last 10 nights. Which are the last 10 nights? These last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is taking qasam upon. I will just share one hadith with you, and then I will finish. And that's the hadith from Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. And this hadith is mentioned in Sahih Muslim. She said, when the last 10 days of the month of Ramadan would come, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would do three things. When the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan began, Prophet ﷺ would do three things. Number one, shidda mi'zarahu. He would tighten his belt. He would tighten his belt. I know this is the expression that we should all understand, because even in English we say, like, buckle it up, right? You all say, buckle it up. What does it mean, buckle it up? It means that now I'm going to take things seriously. No, this is the final run. This is the end. I can see the finish line. And even psychologically, when you see the finish line, what do? You give your best. You go, you run, and you get there. This is the time when your enthusiasm gets the highest. That's what it means. Shadda mi'zarahu. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha is telling us that in the last 10 nights, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would tighten his belt. That this is the time I will do everything to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Unfortunately, brothers, unfortunately, a lot of us, including myself, you know, there is a thing that we call Ramadan burnout syndrome. You know, we burn it out in the first 10 nights, or in the first 20 nights. And when the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan come, they are the weakest of the entire month of Ramadan. You know, a lot of us, including myself, we are fresh and we are more better in the first night of the month of Ramadan than we are in the 21st night of the month of Ramadan. And this shows we don't understand. We don't really understand. We need to understand that the first 10 days, the first 20 days is just an exercise for all of us. So that when we see the last 10 nights, when we see the last finish line, when we see the end, then we give our utmost. And the good news for all of us, for people like me, for people like us, it's a good news for all of us that we were not so energetic in the first 20 nights of the month of Ramadan. We were not. So now we have time. We have time to put some effort in these last 10 nights. We have time to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, Ya Allah, even though I don't have that kind of iman, I don't have that kind of righteousness that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to have, that Sahaba used to have, but still, Ya Allah, I love you. I will do something for you in the last 10 nights. I will. This is a time for us to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, Ya Allah, we still love you. We still love you. Because at the end of the day, the reality is that you need to get to the finish line. This is the most important thing. You know, even in the recaps of all the races, they always show you the last bit of the race when the runners are getting to the finish line, because this is the most important thing. This is the most important thing. And we are in this stage now. We are in the beginning of the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan. So make dua. Make dua to Allah. Shadda mi'zarahu. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would tighten his belt, and we would tighten our belt as well. And we do something for the sake of Allah in the last 10 nights, inshallah. So this is the first thing he would do. Second thing, ahya laylahu. He would awake the entire night. He would stay awake the entire night. Ibn Taymiyyah and other scholars of Islam, they have said that we don't know of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam spending the entire night worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala except in the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan. As a routine, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would worship every night as a routine. But as a routine, he would never stay awake the entire night worshipping Allah except in the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan. Last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan, he would spend the entire night awake worshipping Allah. He would only go to bed after Fajr Salah. And believe me, brothers, it's easy to do it here in Scotland. Fajr is half one. It's half one. So it's very easy in here. But in the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Fajr is 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock. So it was difficult for Rasulullah, but he is doing it. So the brothers who can stay awake the entire night, especially Allah reward all of those brothers who are doing itikaf, especially the brothers who are sitting in itikaf. It's the time for them to stay awake the entire night and show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are here to worship you. And I understand and I realize, brothers, I understand that we are living in times, we are living in lands that we have to go to work 7 a.m., 8 a.m. in the morning every day. I understand that. Fair enough. Fair enough. But if you can take off from your work, alhamdulillah. And especially my young brothers and sisters. By young, I mean the ones who are in college and below. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you that the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan is coming during your holidays. Summer holidays. Right? This is the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we don't have school right now, because 1 year from now, 2 years from now, the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan will be coming during your final exams. Then you won't have that kind of opportunity. So thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and take advantage of these last 10 nights. Stay awake, do some kind of zikr, ibadat, some kind of worshipping of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm not saying that resting is haram. In these last 10 nights, you're not allowed to do any kind of rest. No. You want to take some rest? Go ahead and take rest. But we all need to make sure that the solid percentage of our night we are spending worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because that's what Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would do. Ahya laylahu. He would spend the entire night in dua, in zikr, in ibadat, in Quran, in tilawat. Subhanallah. And the last thing, ayqadha ahlahu. He would awake his entire family up. The women in the house, the children in the house, you know, those who can pray, those who can stand up in the prayer, he would wake them up. You know, I understand the sisters, especially the sisters who pray Taraweeh here, they don't have much time. They finish Taraweeh prayers, they go back home, and then they are busy making suhoor for all of us. So I understand that. But still, my suggestion to the sisters, while they are making food, do some kind of zikr, do some kind of dua, do some kind of ibadah, do something that will please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, you cannot perform salah, you cannot stand in a salah, but still do something that will please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And our deen is so easy. You are making food and you are saying subhanallah, subhanallah, subhanallah. You are saying alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. You are saying astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. And good, you are getting reward for that. So it's easy. Now finally, my brothers, you know, who have to go to work early morning and they cannot take off from their work, a very humble suggestion to all of you. Do something in the last 10 nights of the month of Ramadan that you would not do in the rest of the year. Do something special. Do something special. You know, if you cannot stay awake throughout the entire night, then do some ibadah only for half an hour, 40 minutes, 45 minutes, an hour. Take an advantage of an afternoon nap. When you come back home, go to bed. Sleep for an hour or 2 hours. So then when you come here for Taraweeh prayers, inshallah, you will be fresh. And you will try to stay awake as much as possible, inshallah. You cannot stay awake throughout the entire night. Stay awake half of the night, 1/5 of the night, 1/4 of the night. Do something. Show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala something. But one last suggestion for all of you, and then I finish, inshallah. One last suggestion. Brother, let me finish. One last suggestion. If we cannot stay awake at all, and we cannot do anything, let me tell you the hadith of Rasulullah, and I'm very hopeful that after listening to this hadith, inshallah, we all will be willing to do it, inshallah. All of us, because it's a very easy thing. All of us will be willing to do it. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prayed Taraweeh prayers twice in his lifetime. He prayed Taraweeh prayers how many times? Twice in his last time. One of these Taraweeh prayers, when he finished Taraweeh prayers, it was one of the odd night of the last 10 night of the month of Ramadan. So he finished Taraweeh prayers, You say, Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah, Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah. And a Sahabi came to Rasulullah, a companion of Rasulullah came to Rasulullah. He said, Ya Rasulullah, لو تنفلت لنا إلى الصباح. Subhanallah. He said, Ya Rasulullah, why can't we continue praying this salah until Fajr salah? Why can't we continue praying this salah until Fajr salah? Let's do it the whole night. Let's do it until Fajr salah. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Man salla ma'a al-imam. That whoever worships with imam, whoever prays his salah with imam, the entire prayer, hatta yansarifa, until he says assalamu alaikum, until he finishes the whole salah, kutiba lahu qiyamul layl, that person will get the reward of the entire night. You just have to start your salah with imam, and you have to finish your salah with imam. Brothers, mashallah, most of you brothers, you stay here until 12 o'clock. Give me half an hour more. Give me half an hour more. And we all will finish our Tarawih prayers, inshallah, at half 12. You will start your Tarawih prayers with me, inshallah. You will finish your Tarawih prayers with me, and you will get the reward of the entire night. And don't forget, one of these nights is Laylatul Qadr. One of these nights is the night of power. You worship in that night, and you will get the reward of 83 years. So why would you miss out that opportunity? This is a time for us to go an extra mile. All of us, for all of us, to go an extra mile. You know, when you have been running for 30 minutes for a very, very long time, your trainer will tell you, now you should run for 35 minutes. And this extra 5 minutes, this will do for you. So now this is a time for us to run for extra 5 minutes. Run for extra 10, 20, 30 minutes, inshallah. And this will do for us. So are you ready for this night, inshallah? I promise all of you brothers, inshallah, I will finish at half 12, inshallah. So we all start our salah together, we finish our salah together, inshallah, and we'll get the reward of the entire night, inshallah. So are you ready for this night, inshallah? May Allah grant us understanding.